Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to see the numerical on sinking of support in a continuous beam. This is part 2. In unit number 2, moment and distribution method for the subject structural analysis 2. In the first video on numerical on sinking of support in continuous beam, we have seen the statement of the numerical problem. Then we have find out the friction moment in different members of a continuous beam ABC. So friction moment in member AB, it is 106.67. Friction moment in member BA, it is minus 106.67. Friction moment in member BC is plus 30 kN meter. And friction moment in member CB, it is minus 30 kN meter. These are the condition for the relative stiffness for different members in a beam. Then we have found out in the last video the distribution factor for member BA and BC for a joint B. So the distribution factor for member BA is 0.57 and distribution factor for member BC is 0.43. Then we have calculated the moment in member AB as well as in BA, BC and CB. So moment in member BA is 114.17. Moment in member BA is minus 99.70. These are the fixed moment. So fixed moment in member BC is plus 15 kN meter and fixed moment in members CB, it is minus 45 kN meter. Okay. Now the next is the moment distribution. Okay. Now the first row is member. Now in members are, first member is AB, second member is BA, then BC and CB. So these are the members of a continuous beam ABC. Now next row is the distribution factor. Already we have found out the distribution factor for member BA as 0.57 and distribution factor for member BC as 0.43. Okay, then we have calculated the friction moment by considering the effect of sinking as well as the friction moment due to the given load. Okay, so friction moment in member AB is 114.17, friction moment in member BA is minus 99.170, friction moment in member BC is plus 15 and friction moment in member CB is minus 45. Now next is the balance or the correction. Now if you see the figure at joint C, there is a simple support. When the simple support is there, then moment in member CB, it will be equal to 0. But in moment distribution table, if you see here the value is given minus 45. So the moment in member CB, it should be 0. So here you have to make this moment equal to 0. So here you have to apply the correction of plus 45. So minus 45 plus 45. So then this moment will be equal to 0. So why this moment is 0? Because here at joint C or at support C, there is simple support. So moment in member CB, it will be equal to 0. So when here at CB, when we apply plus 45, so half will be get transferred to the far end, that is BC. Next member, that is BC. So here 45 divided by 2, so we'll get 22.5. So plus 22.5. Okay. Now, next we have to find out the initial moment. Now here initial moments are nothing but fixed moment plus balance. So for member AB, the moment will be 114.17 plus balance, that is 0. So initial moment will be 114.17. So the initial moment in member BA, it will be a minus 99.17 plus 0. So it is minus 99.17. For member BC, it is plus 15 plus 22.5. So the initial moment in member BC is 37.5. Okay. The initial moment in member CB is 0, minus 45 plus 45, so it is 0. So these are the initial moment. Now if you consider the equilibrium of joint B, in at joint B, two members are connecting, that is BA and BC. So moment in member BA and plus moment in member BC, it should be equal to zero. But in moment distribution table, if you see, moment in member BA is minus 99.17 and moment in member BC is 37.5. So if you take the difference of minus 99.17 plus 37.5, it comes to be equal to minus 61.67. So here difference is 61.67, and that difference is, so that difference is negative. So here the correcting moment will be positive. So difference in the moment of the two members is negative, so the correcting moment will be positive. So this correcting moment is to be distributed in member B and BC in proportion of the distribution factor. Okay, so the component of the correcting moment in member BA, it will be 61.67 multiplied by the distribution factor of member BA is 0.57. So we get the value as 35.21. Okay, so the component of the correcting moment in member BC, it will be 61.67 multiplied by 0.43. So that value will be 26.46. Okay, now this distribution moment will be transferred to the far end depending upon the condition. From B to A, the far end is fixed. So when the far end is fixed, this carryover is allowed and it is half. So 35.21 divided by 2, so it is 17.61. Okay, now from B to C, the condition is, from B to C, if you see, the far end is simple and beam is not continuous. So in this case, the carrier is not allowed. So here it is 0. Okay, now here there is no any movement at joint B. So here we have to stop it and find out the final moment. So final moment will be from initial moment you have to do the addition. So 114.17 plus the carryover moment, that is 17.61. So final moment in member AB will be 131.78. okay, now the final moment in member BA, it will be minus 99.17 plus 35.21, it will be minus 63.96. The final moment in member BC, it will be 37.5 plus 26.56, it will be 63.96. And final moment in member CB is 0. So these are the final moments for the different members of a continuous beam ABC. Next we have to draw the superimposed bending moment diagram. So first we'll draw the horizontal line. So at support A, the moment is 131.78, so we show it 131.78. So at point B, it is 63.96. as we know that if it is plus or minus, here you have to show above this horizontal line. So here value is 63.96. okay, now at CB, the value is 0. So this we have to connect by a straight line. This is fixed bending moment. Now next you have to draw the free bending moment diagram. Okay, free bending moment diagram is due to the given load. In portion or in member AB, it is loaded by a uniformly distributed load. So the value of free bending moment diagram, as we know that it is W L square by 8. It is W L square by 8. So W L is 20, value of L is 8. Okay, so W, the 20 into 8 square by 8. So this value would be 160. Now in member BC, it is loaded by point load and that point load is at the center. So value of free bending moment diagram will be WL upon 4. So value of W here is 60 and L, that is length of the member BC, is 4. So value will be 60. Okay, so this for member AB, as it is loaded by a uniformly distributed load, so you have to join by a second degree curve. And in member BC, as there is a point load, so we have to join it by a straight line. Okay, so this is combination of fixed and free bending moment diagram. So this diagram is called as superimposed bending moment diagram. Okay, next we have to draw the shear force diagram. To find out the shear force diagram, you have to find out the support reaction. Okay. Now here the support reaction will be due to the given loading as well as due to the unbalanced moment. Now in portion AB, it is loaded by a uniformly distributed load. So the end reaction due to this load will be WL by 2. So value of W is here 20, length of member is 8. So 20 into 8 divided by 2. So this value will be equal to 80. 80 at support A, 80 at support B. Now in member BC, it is loaded by a point load at the center. Okay. So the end reaction will be equal to W by 2. So value of W here is 60, 60 divided by 2, it is 30, 30. Now, already we have found out the fixed moment in member. Already I find out the fixed moment in member AB, BA, BC, okay, and CB. Now here, the fixed moment in member AB, it is in anticlockwise direction, as shown wrong sign here. So it is in anticlockwise direction because it is plus 131.79. When it is plus, our sign convention is it is acting in anticlockwise direction. Okay. Now in member BA, it is minus 63.93. When it is minus 63.90, that means it is acting in clockwise direction. Okay. So here we have to find out the unbalanced moment. Okay. Now here unbalanced moment will be in anticlockwise direction, because here if you compare the two moment, the value of 131.79 is greater than 63.90. So unbalanced moment will be in anticlockwise direction. Okay. So what a so end reaction should rotate the structure in clockwise direction. Okay. So at support B, here the value should be here the reaction should be downward, and at support A it should be upward. Or where the unbalanced moment is acting, there you should upward, and at the far end you show it downward. Okay. So the reaction due to unbalanced moment, it will be, so this will be, as it is acting anticlockwise direction, so 131.79 plus minus 63.93 divided by the length of the member, that is 8. So we get the value as 8.483. At joint at A, it will act in upward direction, at B it will act in downward direction. Now the unbalanced moment in member BA, okay, it is 63.93 because there is only one moment, okay, at B it is acting in anticlockwise direction, or the value we get is plus 63.93. When it is plus, that means the moment is acting in anticlockwise direction. Okay. Now when the moment is acting in anticlockwise direction, that is, this will be the unbalanced moment, and the to balance this, the reaction should rotate the structure in clockwise direction. So here the reaction should be downward, and here it should be upward. Okay, anticlockwise, unbalanced movement will rotate in anticlockwise direction, and reaction will rotate in clockwise direction. So here it should be downward, and here it should be upward. Here unbalanced movement, so upward, far end downward. So reaction due to unbalanced movement will be 63.93 divided by the length of the member 4. So we get the value as 15.98. Okay. Then we have to find out the reaction due to the addition of these two, due to the loading and unbalanced movement. Okay. So here at support A, it is due to the given loading, the reaction is 80, it is acting upward, and due to the unbalanced movement, it is 8.483, both are acting upward, so positive. So reaction at A will be 88.48. Now at B, support B, reaction due to the given loading is 80, and reaction due to unbalanced movement is acting downward, and it is minus 8.483. So 80 minus 8.483 minus, because it is acting downward. So reaction at support B for member B is 71.32. Now reaction at support B for member BC, due to the given loading it is 30, and due to the unbalanced movement it is 15.98, both are acting upward, so plus. So 30 plus 15.98, the value is 45.98. So reaction at B will be 71.52 plus 45.98, it will be 117.50, and it will be in upward direction. Okay. So reaction at support C, due to the loading it is 30, acting upward, and due to unbalanced movement it is acting downward, so minus 15.98. So the addition of reaction at support C will be 30 minus 15.98. It will be equal to 14.02. And it will act in upward direction. Okay. Now, as we know the support reaction, so we can draw the shear force diagram. So first you have to draw the horizontal line. At support A, the value is 88.48. So show here 88.48. In portion AB, it is loaded in member AB, it is loaded by a uniformly distributed load of 20 kilonewton per meter. So 88.48 minus 20 into 8. So we get the value as 71.52. It is minus. So reaction at B is 117.5. So 71.52 minus plus 117.5. So we get the value as 45.98. Okay, in this portion no load, so joined by a horizontal line. So here there is a point load of 60 kilonewton acting downward. So 45.98 minus 60. So we get the value as 14.02. In this portion there is no load. So you have to join by a straight line. The value is 14.02. So reaction at C, it is 14.02. Okay. So for minus 14.02 plus 14.02. So the value at C is 0. So this is the shear force diagram for the given continuous B. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.